This special broadcast of the 18th annual JCN Person of the Year is brought to you by the following sponsors: Hannah's Hardware, Original Patties, Frank Hanna Janitorial, Janae's Uniform Center, Lil General's Convenience Store, New Covenant Baptist Church, Bethel Baptist Church, J.S. Johnson Insurance, and Kemp Road Ministries. The Seventh-day Adventist churches in the Bahamas also extend congratulations to Pastor Leonard Johnson on being named JCN Person of the Year 2018.
Your Excellency, Dame Marguerite Bindling, Prime Minister, the Most Honorable Hubert Minnis, our Person of the Year honorees, Reverend Dr. Timothy Stewart and Dr. Leonard Johnson, other members of the clergy, government officials, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It is our pleasure to welcome you to the JCN Media Center and to the 18th Annual Person of the Year Awards. We'll now have the invocation by Reverend Dr. C.B. Moss.
Let us pray. Gracious, merciful, and loving God, for a moment we turn our attention away from the hustle and bustle of the world around us as we look unto you, the giver of all good and perfect gifts and the source of our strength. We offer you heartfelt thanks for our nation, for all of our leaders, and for those who contribute to the continued development of our nation. We especially thank you, O God, for our heroes and our honorees, Dr. Timothy Stewart and Dr. Leonard Johnson, who are today being recognized for their outstanding contributions to your kingdom and to nation building. Thank you also for your servant, Wendell Jones, who, in accordance with your word, found in Philippians chapter 2, verse 3, constantly seek to esteem others better than himself. We invite your holy presence into our midst to guide and to bless, and we pray that whatever is said and done will be to your honor and your glory and for the advancement of your kingdom. Bless now the food that we shall eat, and may it remind us that you will always provide for our needs. These favors we ask in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you, Dr. Moss. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome the Chairman and CEO of Jones Communications Network, Mr. Wendell Jones, who will speak on the occasion.
Thank you very much, Kim. Your Excellency, the Most Honorable Dame Marguerite Bindling, Prime Minister, the Most Honorable Dr. Minnis, our honorees and your families, members of the clergy, ladies and gentlemen, a pleasant good afternoon. Welcome to the Jones Communications Center, a place where issues and people are analyzed, and where news is often made and published. Today we are making sweet news, we hope, and we are here to bestow honors on our persons of the year, two clerics who have made us proud on the global stage. 18 years ago, the management of Jones Communications, in keeping with our mission, decided that we should hold an annual event to inspire Bahamians to strive for excellence and to be world class in every aspect of life. Hence, we decided that at the end of every year, a special committee would choose that Bahamian who uses heart, head, and hands to strengthen the fabric of our society and our shared humanity. In 2000, when we produced the book, The Most Outstanding Bahamians of the 20th Century, we chose the father of the nation, the late Sir Lyndon Pindling, as our first person of the year and the man of the century. Since then, we have chosen Bahamian luminaries like Archbishop Drexel Gomez upon his election to head the Anglican Church in the province of the West Indies. Others followed, like outstanding politicians, physicians, clergymen, businessmen, and athletes. They have been trailblazers in empowering Bahamians, and they gave inspiration to many Bahamians and inspired them in leadership as well. Both of our honorees today are from humble beginnings. They are both former students of Prince William Baptist High School. Both were attracted to the Christian ministry from tender ages. And both have been elected in two different denominations to reach the hearts and souls of millions as drum majors with the Christian message of faith. And so while we in the media business, we bring you news as journalists, these men are sent by God to announce the gospel, the good news. Unlike ours, their calling is more specific. In every corner of the Bahamas, where we are living in another dimension of the Industrial Revolution, the technological age, where there is a new morality, it seems, and new realities with new social strictures, these men are on the front line of the battlefield to remind us that the good news of Christ is the only relevancy yesterday, today, and forever. Our survival and upward mobility depend on an understanding of our common humanity and how we are to be able to get our fellow men in the Bahamas to follow the Christian faith. And this is why, as a media organization, we are pleased to draw attention to the Reverend Dr. Timothy Stewart, who leads the Progressive National Baptist Convention, USA Incorporated, and Dr. Leonard Johnson, Executive Secretary of the Inter-American Division of Seventh-day Adventists. They are Bahamians who are extraordinary in providing leadership on the global stage. To emerge as leaders of these organizations, you must be world-class in character, world-class in education, and world-class in leadership. World-class suggests both the need to meet the highest standards anywhere in order to compete, and the growth of a social class defined by its ability to command resources and operate successfully beyond borders. It is our hope that these awards will excite Bahamians to the plains of excellence and inspire them to become global in their outlook as well as in their performance. Ladies and gentlemen, last year we gave the Person of the Year award to an outstanding Bahamian who used heart, head, and hands, and who inspired Bahamians everywhere. He became the Prime Minister of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. And over the last many months, we have seen that he has worked tirelessly to improve the quality of life of Bahamians everywhere. And so it gives me great pleasure at this time to ask our Prime Minister, the Most Honorable Dr. Hubert Minnis, to come to the podium to bring remarks. Dr. Minnis.
Thank you very much. You may be seated. Your Excellency, Most Honorable Dame Margaret Pinling, Governor General of Commonwealth of Bahamas, award recipients, special guests, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It gives me great pleasure to be here today at this special ceremony to honor Reverend Dr. Timothy Stewart and Dr. Leonard Johnson. These two esteemed religious leaders are being recognized for their contributions to the development of our nation. Congratulations on receiving the Jones Communication Network Person of the Year Award for 2018. This award honors outstanding Bahamians who have made significant contributions to the political, social, civic, and economic development of our Bahamas. The award was started 18 years ago by the CEO of JCN, Wendell Jones. Its past recipients have included former prime ministers, well-known members of the clergy, businessmen, athletes, and physicians. I am the proud recipient of the 2017 Person of the Year Award. This year, the award is being given jointly to Reverend Dr. Stewart and Dr. Johnson, who have contributed significantly through their respective churches to the Bahamas, and who are now making an impact on the international stage. Religious leaders play a powerful role in our society. They help shape attitudes and opinions and influence behaviors. Reverend Dr. Timothy Stewart is the pastor of the historic Bethel Baptist Church on Meeting Street. Bethel Baptist Church holds the distinction of being the oldest Baptist church in our Bahamas. As one historian noted, for over two centuries, it has anchored the spiritual life of a segment of the Over the Hill community. Reverend Dr. Stewart has served as the church's pastor for almost four decades. Bethel Baptist Church played an important role in the struggle for social equality leading up to majority rule. Reverend Dr. Stewart has preserved the trailblazing legacy of the church that was first formed by Samuel Scriven and Prince Williams in 1790 as Bethel's Meeting House. This year, Reverend Dr. Stewart will serve as president of the Progressive National Baptist Convention in the U.S., which has an estimated membership of 2.5 million. A statement announcing this year's JCN Person of the Year's Award describes Dr. Stewart as an inspiration to clergymen and members of the community of faith in the Bahamas and the Americas. Dr. Johnson, a Seventh-day Adventist pastor, was recently installed as the first pastor for an English-speaking territory to become executive secretary of the Inter-American Division of Seventh-day Adventist Churches. The division has a membership of more than 3 million and oversees the church's work in 42 countries. Dr. Johnson has served in ministry for many years. He is celebrated for outstanding preaching ministry. In 2016, Dr. Johnson was the first Seventh-day Adventist minister to receive the CMG Medal in the Bahamas. Let me also thank the Baptist community and the Seventh-day Adventist Church for their tremendous contributions to our Bahamas, including in education and social development. Ladies and gentlemen, it is essential that we honor those who contribute to the development of our society. Public recognition helps to ensure that their contributions do not fade from our national memory. It also helps nurture a strong sense of community and national pride. It sets a good example for others and offers young people a source of inspiration. Thank you, Mr. Jones, for seeing the value in recognizing citizens who make a difference. When I accepted this award last year, I said that, and I quote, "While we have our different political, religious, and other affiliations, we have a shared vision and ambition to make ours a land of opportunity with a commitment to the common good, to social justice, and to helping the least among us live better lives," end quote. Awards like this one is a reminder that there are many Bahamians who are doing their part to build a better Bahamas. Thank you, Dr. Stewart and Dr. Johnson, for your respective ministries and witness to faith and the common good. May God continue to bless our Bahamas. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and good afternoon.
Thank you, Prime Minister, for your kind remarks today. And I just would like for all of you to know that we have a red room where we have your photograph now mounted among the other luminaries over the years, over the last 18 years that we have been staging these awards. Thank you so very much, sir, for your remarks. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now going to ask two individuals from the denominations where our honorees are serving to introduce them today so that we might be able to present them the awards. To introduce Dr. Leonard Johnson, it is my pleasure to call on my good friend of many years who started with me as a news reporter way back then, more than 40 years ago, Dr. Elliston Rumming, to introduce his leader, Dr. Leonard Johnson. Dr. Rumming.
Since its founding in 1863, with some 3,500 members, the Seventh-day Adventist Church has grown into the fifth largest Christian community worldwide, with a membership that exceeds 20 million, scattered across some 215 countries and territories. The church owns and operates over 7,500 schools, inclusive of over 100 colleges and universities, numerous hospitals and clinics, and an impressive list of publishing, broadcast, and telecast entities. Headquartered in Maryland, in the United States, the Seventh-day Adventist Church is divided operationally and administratively into 13 geographical divisions, one of which is the Inter-American Division, headquartered in Miami, Florida, which boasts a membership of over 3.5 million, encompassing Mexico, the Caribbean, Central America, and the five northernmost countries of South America. Within the Inter-American Division, there are in excess of 11,000 churches that serve a population of 300 million. Having regard to the foregoing, it was a stellar accomplishment for the Bahamas and the English-speaking Caribbean in March 2018, when Dr. Leonard Johnson, a son of our soil, was elected to serve as Executive Secretary of the Inter-American Division of Seventh-day Adventists, a position just one seat away from the presidency. By assuming this post, Dr. Johnson has risen to higher heights within the church superstructure than any other Bahamian. Indeed, he is the first person from an English-speaking territory to be so elevated. Academically and experientially, one may say he took the stairs, not the elevator, to success. The product of a modest, humble beginning, Dr. Johnson holds bachelor's and master's degrees from Northern Caribbean University in Jamaica, and an earned doctorate in ministry from the Reformed Theological Seminary in Jackson, Mississippi. During his 36 years as a pulpiter and biblical scholar, his service has run the gamut from pastor to conference department director, to conference executive secretary, to conference president, to union president, and now executive secretary of the Inter-American Division of Seventh-day Adventist. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me in tributizing Dr. Leonard Johnson.
I'd like the Governor General, please, to assist me in presenting the awards right now. Dr. Johnson.
Your Excellency, Prime Minister, religious leaders, in particular, the leader of our conference, Dr. or Pastor Kenny DeVoe, colleagues, friends, families, and distinguished persons. Firstly, let me express my appreciation to Dr. Ramming for his kind words of introduction on this occasion. As I stand here today as a recipient of this distinguished award, I'm humbled for many reasons, because as I think about this award, Mr. Jones, I cannot help but think about the many persons that God has placed in my path, who have helped to shape, to mold, to fashion, and to develop what you see and whom you praise. But it's also incumbent upon me on an occasion like this to express appreciation to the one who has endowed me with talents, with gifts, and with abilities, and who has blessed my parents, both deceased, to bring this person into the world. I speak of Almighty God. And as I think about the many of you, I cannot help but quote a favorite piece of mine by Mitch Albom. He makes the following point: things that happen before you are born still affect you, and people who come before your time affect you as well. We move through places every day that would never have been possible were not for those whom God has placed in our path. And so what you see today did not begin with myself and with my colleague, Dr. Timothy Stewart. It really began with Almighty God, began with you. And so as I accept this award on this occasion, I do so cognizant of the church. Firstly, the Baptist denomination, where I had my early beginning, and significantly, the Seventh-day Adventist Church, since 1976, when I became a member. This church that accorded me the privilege and the opportunities to serve at every single level just about in the church, and to travel and traverse so many places throughout the world. And so today, I stand as a member of this church, and I give this honor to my church for what it has done for me and through me. And then I also stand in this capacity, finally, as a proud Bahamian, serving at the Inter-American Division headquarters. As I travel throughout Central America, Mexico, yea, throughout the world, I never forget my Bahamas. As always, a proud thing to come back and to be able to celebrate this wonderful place. So once again, I say thanks to all of you, Mr. Jones. Thanks to the committee responsible for this award. Thanks to my colleagues, my church. Thanks to my friends who have come, my family, and in a very special way, to the lady who has been with me for 35 years, my dear wife, best friend, and companion. God bless you all.
Thank you so very much, Dr. Leonard Johnson. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure now to call on our good friend and someone who I've come to love as a great pulpiteer, who has adopted me and adopted Jones Communications. I can say more, but I don't want people to become too envious. And so I would like to call the Reverend T.G. Morrison, the pastor of Zion Baptist Church, to introduce our next honoree, Dr. Stewart.
Your Excellency, the Most Honorable Dame Magri Pindling, the Most Honorable Dr. Hubert Minnis. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven. While avoiding the snare of lionization, it is yet honorable to pause in a cradle-like form to trace the hand of providence upon one whose light continues to shine before others, and as a result has brought us in August assembly at this existential moment. A male child conceived in a loving and committed marital relationship, privileged to share the womb with another male child, raised in a large but closely knitted family, and from very early nurtured in the tenets of the Judeo-Christian faith, but giving expression to that faith within the context of the Baptist tradition. This one, whom we pause to honor, took seriously his formative rearing, and in time, personally made profession of faith in Jesus the Christ, and by grace, counting the cost, embraced the mandate to be salt and light. Though the son of Baptist pastors, who were trailblazers in their own right, he heard for himself and accepted God's call to Christian ministry. He submitted himself to the process of ministerial formation in the formal academic setting of seminary, and at the kairotic moment was ordained a minister of word and sacrament in Christ's church. Likened unto a young sapling, the hand of providence led him to the pastorate of Bethel Baptist Church, and from there he engaged in national, regional, and international partnerships. His gifts made room for him and literally brought him before great men. Yet none of these things moved him, for he was at the base of all a passionate and a faithful pastor, a trustworthy prophetic voice, a voice for the sovereign God, the God who called and continues to sustain him in the execution of the ministry of reconciliation. This man of God is cognizant that the way to the throne room is through the servants' quarters, and a serve he has, and a serve he continues to do, for he understands that he must work the works of him who sent him while it is day, for night comes when no one can work. This man is a living proof that whatever God has for you, you will get it, even if the devil has to bring it. For at this time, he is the first in the history of the Progressive Baptist Convention, the Baptist convention that gave haven to the likes of the late Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. He now, a non-American, a non-resident of the United States, has been elected and will be inducted as president of this ecclesial body, because truly they are progressive people. This man, therefore, has emerged as a shining light, and with the confidence reposed in him, testifies to the same. In fact, so effulgent is his light that the CEO, management and staff of Jones Communication Network, they have seen his rays and have summoned us all here today to honor this man, one of God's choicest sons. Therefore, without delay, I introduce and present this honoree, the pastor of the oldest continuous Baptist church in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas and the entire Caribbean, established in 1790. The moderator of the Bethel Baptist Association of Churches. The first non-American president of the Progressive Baptist Convention. Sister Sharon's husband, Gardner's father, Alfred's brother, a true servant of God whose heart continues to shine because he understands in true Baptist style that he must let his lower light keep burning, sending the gleam across the way. For some poor, struggling seaman, he may rescue, he may save. Reverend Dr. Timothy Stewart.
Kim, I would just like to announce that that is our pastor pro tem. Right? Right, Deacon Cox?
Yes.
Yes. Let us now ask Her Excellency to join us again, please.
Your Excellency, the Honorable Dame Margaret Pinling, the Most Honorable Hubert Minnis, our Prime Minister, to the Executive CEO and the family of Jones Communication Network, to my fellow honoree and his wife, to our leader of the opposition, Mr. Philip Brave Davis, to all of the outstanding clergy persons here this afternoon, to you, my distinguished brothers and sisters, it is such a joy to be here today. Let me first say that I believe that God deposits, provides leadership with regards to the challenges of every age. In other words, I believe that we who lead, we have been mandated and gifted in such a way to deal with the challenges of our age. And so I believe it was no accident that God allowed me to be born into the family that I was born in, to be nurtured in such a way and shaped, fashioned in such a way that the tremendous work and contributions and challenges that he had prepared for me could be properly prepared. And so today, I want to publicly thank first my family, my parents, my wife and children. I want to thank my church family, the Bethel Baptist Church, that have been the tremendous platform and avenue through which God, through his grace, has allowed me to minister for the last 36 years. I want to thank God for being part of this Bahamian community at this pivotal juncture in history, where the best and the brightest are being sought and called for in order to contribute to the tremendous areas that this country needs so badly. I want to thank God for the Progressive National Baptist Convention that provided me the opportunity to lead them at this time. And so, my brothers and sisters, today, as I stand here, I want to thank Brother Jones, who, through his stellar contributions through media and communications, have continued to provide this nation a tremendous standard and quality that we are all proud of today. Once again, I want to thank my fellow honoree, who we have known for so many years, for the outstanding work he and his family are doing within our sister denomination. So may God richly bless us as we continue through our various and varied and diverse efforts to continue to work for the advancement, the development, the growth, and the strengthening of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Stewart. Normally, after the preaching, there is the altar call. And ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be favored now with not a sound to bring you to the altar, but for your enjoyment from a great Seventh-day Adventist who is in our midst. It's our pleasure now to ask Harold Dorsett to come along and render a solo. Mr. Dorsett, give him a hand, please.
Pilgrims on a journey of the narrow road, and those who've gone before us line the way, cheering on the faithful, encouraging the weary, their lives a stirring testament to God's sustaining grace. Surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us run this race not only for the prize, but as those who've gone before us, let us leave to those behind us the heritage of faithfulness passed on through godly lives. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light their way. May the footprints that we leave lead them to believe, and the lives we live inspire them to obey. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. After all our hopes and dreams have come and gone, and our children sift through all we've left behind. May the clues that they discover and the memories they uncover becomes the light that leads them to the road we each must find. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light their way. May the footprints that we leave lead them to believe, and the lives we live inspire them to obey. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light their way. May the footprints that we them to believe, and the lives we live inspire them to obey. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful.
Thank you so very much, Mr. Dorsett. I know that you are Seventh-day Adventist, but I know too, in the interest of even-handedness, Sister Cox, that you would expect a Baptist soloist. But I just want to inform all of you Baptists that he has Baptist in his DNA. So that will suffice. So thank you so very much. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd just like to pause now to just salute some of the people I see in our audience who have been persons of the year over the last 18 years. And I mentioned earlier Archbishop Gomez, and we see Dr. Magnus Ekididi, who did a wonderful job in surgery, and Dr. Leon Williams, who did a whole lot of work in the business of telephony, and I don't think I'm missing out any other person of the year here today. But I'd also like to recognize the number of clergymen that we have in our midst this afternoon. Many names here, but particularly I'd like to mention Bishop Michael C. Simonet, who is my great friend, who is here this afternoon. Every time we ask him to attend one of our functions, he would make it, and so I'd just like to single him out. We've come to the end of our program this afternoon, and we'd just like for you to please stay behind and enjoy some of the refreshments that we have provided. I'd like to thank you all for supporting the Jones Communications Network over the last 24 and a half years. We're gonna make a big deal of our 25th anniversary very soon, and so we'd invite you back here in this space, hopefully to celebrate with us. But thank you so very much, Your Excellency, for gracing us with your presence, Mr. Prime Minister, and all of you distinguished guests for being here this afternoon. I'd just like to invite the Prime Minister, the Governor General, and the honorees, if you can come to the front for a group photograph. And thank you so very much. Please enjoy the refreshment this afternoon. Thank you.
special JCN broadcast of the 18th Annual Person of the Year was brought to you by the following sponsors: Hannah's Hardware, Original Patties, Frank Hanna Janitorial, Janae's Uniform Center, Lil General's Convenience Store, New Covenant Baptist Church, Bethel Baptist Church, J.S. Johnson Insurance, and Kemp Road Ministries. The Seventh-day Adventist churches in the Bahamas also extend congratulations to Pastor Leonard Johnson on being named JCN Person of the Year 2018.